Hello and thanks for watching Proactive. I'm joined by Alex Valdes. He's the Chief Financial Officer at Trust Stamp. Alex, very good to meet you.
Likewise, Stephen. Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. Alex, you're just up with your second quarter results. Can you take us through some of the highlights, perhaps starting with customer growth?
Absolutely. I appreciate the opportunity to speak with you today. This quarter, and indeed the entire year, we've seen pivotal shifts in the company. Those are most evident in three key dimensions. First and foremost, we've experienced a surge in customer growth and diversification, really propelled by our orchestration layer SaaS platform, which we've launched earlier this year. Secondly, we've undertaken strategic cost reductions, which we've redirected into building our sales team and further driving customer growth with the SaaS platform. And finally, we've doubled our commitment to innovation and driving long-term value through continued investment in R&D.
Alex, you mentioned customer growth. Can you expand a little bit on that, please?
Yeah, absolutely. While government contracts have contributed significantly to past revenues, our focus has been on and continues to be on diversifying our client base by reducing overhead and diverting resources chiefly to further developing and scaling our SaaS platform. The orchestration layer is a low-code solution for customers designed to be a one-stop shop for all of our identity services. It really provides an easy integration for enterprise customers with all of our products and is chargeable on a per-user or per-use basis. So each of our current and future products can be built into the OL. So in effect, this platform really becomes a catalyst for the company in transforming the business model from being a custom solutions provider to generating a high margin, scalable, recurring, and even predictable SaaS revenue. Over the past 6 months, we've seen significant growth with the platform. At the end of Q2, we had 29 financial institutions with 1,500 branches and combined assets of over $1.5 trillion already integrated into the OL. So that's an over 280% increase in our financial institution customer base just in the first half of this year alone. And with projections from our channel partner, we're aiming to onboard 45 to 50 financial institutions by the year's end. I think it's also worth noting that TrustStamp's earliest customer, a Fortune 500 bank that's been with us since 2016, is transitioning to the platform and should be fully integrated by the first quarter of 2024. So although for this year, we're expecting relatively nominal revenue from the SaaS platform, we're very excited about the potential for substantial recurring revenue into next year.
Tell us more about the cost reductions that you've implemented, Alex.
Absolutely. A major driver for expense reduction this year has been the cost-cutting campaign that we kicked off towards the end of last year. The result of this campaign is already bearing a lot of fruit. In the second quarter alone, there was a $550,000 reduction in personnel-related overhead compared to last year. Additionally, year-to-date, we saw a sharp decline in over $1.8 million or 30% of our SG&A expense compared to the same time in 2022. And we're also seeing improvements across all of our margins. For example, despite onboarding 23 enterprise clients year to date, we've reduced cost of sales by over 60% compared to the prior year. Additionally, during last quarter, we saw double-digit improvements in our net margin. So among other things, these improvements really magnify the results of our cost-cutting efforts and the low margins enjoyed by SaaS offerings, such as the orchestration layer.
How about your balance sheet? How does that look after your fundraising efforts this year, Alex?
Yeah, our financial position has notably improved over the past few quarters. As of June 30th, we had approximately $5 million in our bank accounts, which is a 300% increase from year end. And this was really made possible primarily through two registered direct offerings that we made in April and June of this year, which generated over $7.5 million in net proceeds. So our commitment to sound financial strategy is reflected in our strengthened balance sheet. Stockholders' equity, for example, stood at just under $3.5 million, which is up from $600,000 at year end. And I would be remiss not to mention that the equity balance of $3.5 million was despite a $2.5 million in cash receipts from a non-refundable revenue advance, which we currently have booked as deferred revenue and therefore liability. So once this liability is released into revenue, it will significantly further improve the balance sheet.
Alex, how's your third quarter looking so far? Give us your outlook for the remainder of the year.
Yeah, we're seeing significant promise for the future. And this is really evidenced by enhanced financial metrics across the company. Our strategic pivot from being primarily a custom solutions provider towards being a highly scalable SaaS enterprise is already yielding tangible results. This is evident in our robust customer and diversification, amplified margins, substantial overhead reductions, and reinforced investments in sales through the orchestration layer and innovation through R&D. So we're confident that these strategic shifts will further fortify the balance sheet and produce strong financial performance over the long term.
Alex, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress you make. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Will do. Thank you, Stephen.
Alex Valdes is the Chief Financial Officer at TrustStamp.